Hello everyone, this is the continuation of video series on plasma proteins, and in today's video we will discuss various example of globulins with NEET PG MCQ. To download lecture notes and other interesting stuff related to biochemistry, please visit website biochemistrybasics.com. As we have seen in the previous video, there are three major constituents of plasma proteins. First one is the albumin, second one is the globulins, and the third one is the fibrinogen. And there are three types of globulins. First one is the alpha globulin, second one is the beta globulin, and the third one is the gamma globulin. And again, there are two types of alpha globulin. First one is the alpha 1 globulin, and the second one is the alpha 2 globulin. In today's video, we will discuss all these globulins in detail along with their examples. First, we will discuss alpha 1 globulins. Alpha 1 globulins, they are the glycoprotein and they are synthesized in the liver. And the main function of alpha 1 globulins is they inhibit the trypsin, elastase, and certain other proteases by forming complex with them. So that is the main function of alpha 1 globulins. Now we will see example of alpha 1 globulin. The first example is alpha 1 antitrypsin or alpha 1 protease inhibitor. Second one is alpha 1 fetoprotein, that is also known as the AFP. Third one is retinol binding protein. Fourth one is alpha 1 acid glycoprotein. Fifth one is prothrombin. And the last one is high density lipoprotein, which is also known as the HDL or good cholesterol. So these are the various examples of alpha 1 globulins. Now we will discuss all these alpha 1 globulins in detail. First one is alpha 1 antitrypsin, which is also known as the alpha 1 protease inhibitor. Alpha 1 protease inhibitor inhibits the activity of proteases, particularly elastase, which degrade the elastin. And elastin is the protein which provides elasticity to the lungs. In normal individual, activity of elastase is regulated by alpha 1 antitrypsin. Alpha 1 antitrypsin protects the lung from the injurious effects by binding with the active elastase. In the particular methionine, that is 358 residues, is involved in the binding with the protease. Active elastase binds to the alpha 1 antitrypsin, and after binding to the alpha 1 antitrypsin, this active elastase becomes inactive, which results in no proteolysis, so no tissue damage. So this is how alpha 1 antitrypsin protects the lung tissue from the injurious effects by binding with active protease, that is active elastase. Now, genetic deficiency of alpha 1 antitrypsin can lead to the emphysema, and excessive cigarette smoking can also lead to the emphysema, as cigarette smoking inhibits the activity of alpha 1 antitrypsin. And these two particular statements can be asked as a 2-mark justification question, that is, alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency leads to emphysema, or excessive cigarette smoking causes the emphysema. Now we will see the answer. Cigarette smoking inhibits the activity of alpha 1 antitrypsin by oxidizing the specific methionine residue which is present in the alpha 1 antitrypsin. Thus, alpha 1 antitrypsin no longer inhibits the elastase activity. And cigarette smoking also increases the number of neutrophils in the lung. Therefore, there is increase in the amount of elastase. And elastase then causes the tissue breakdown, and there is a loss of elasticity in the lungs, which leads to the emphysema. That is the answer of the question, that alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency leads to emphysema, or cigarette smoking leads to the emphysema. Another example of alpha 1 globulin is alpha 1 fetoprotein, that is also known as the AFP. AFP is present in the tissues and plasma of fetus. AFP is the low molecular weight glycoprotein which is synthesized mainly in the fetal yolk sac and in the liver. Plasma concentration of AFP fall very rapidly after birth, but minute amount, that is up to 15 mg per deciliter, is present in the plasma of adult. Its production almost completely repressed in normal adult. Now we will see clinical application of alpha fetoprotein. The measurement of alpha 1 fetoprotein have a two important application. First one is in pregnancy by measuring the concentration of amniotic fluid and plasma AFP, we can help in the diagnosis of open neural tube defect. So in open neural tube defect, there is an increase in the AFP concentration. Open neural tube defects are the group of congenital abnormalities caused by the failure of neural tube. And the second one is the Down syndrome, which is the mental subnormality. In the Down syndrome, there is a decrease in the concentration of alpha fetoprotein. And the plasma AFP is greatly increased in hepatoma, that is cancer of liver, and thus it is used as a tumor marker in the diagnosis of carcinoma of liver. That is the clinical application of alpha 1 fetoprotein, that is also known as the AFP. It helps in the diagnosis of open neural tube defect and Down syndrome, and it also helps in the diagnosis of carcinoma of liver. Another example of alpha 1 globulin is the prothrombin. It is synthesized by liver with the help of vitamin K, and it is involved in the blood clotting. Liver damage causes the lengthening of prothrombin time, that is PT time. In the liver damage, there is a lengthening of prothrombin time. Another example of alpha 1 globulin is the alpha 1 acid glycoprotein. It contains higher percentage of carbohydrate with large number of sialic residues. It is synthesized by the liver parenchymal cells. True physiological function of alpha 1 acid glycoprotein is not known yet, and its level is increased in gastrointestinal inflammatory disease and in the malignant neoplasm. Now we will discuss alpha 2 globulins. For example of alpha 2 globulin. First one is the ceruloplasmin. Second one is the alpha 2 macroglobulin. Third one is the transcortin or corticosteroid binding globulin. Fourth one is the heptoglobin. And the last one is the thyroxine binding globulin. These are the example of alpha 2 globulins. First, we will discuss ceruloplasmin, which is a copper containing glycoprotein. It is a major transport protein for the copper, which is essential trace element. Main function of ceruloplasmin is it acts as a peroxidase. That means it causes conversion or oxidation of Fe plus into the Fe plus 3. And after that, this Fe plus 3 can be incorporated with the transferrin, which is the transport and utilization of iron, which help in the transport and utilization of iron. The main function of ceruloplasmin is it has a peroxidase activity, which causes oxidation of Fe plus 2 into the Fe plus 3. And ceruloplasmin level is reduced in the Wilson's disease, malnutrition, nephrosis, and cirrhosis. Another example of alpha 2 globulin is the alpha 2 microglobulin. This is the major alpha 2 globulin, which is a natural inhibitor of endopeptidase such as trypsin, chymotrypsin, plasmin, and thrombin. Plasma alpha 2 microglobulin level is decreased in myeloma, peptic ulcer, and it is increased in nephrotic syndrome, cirrhosis, and collagen disorders. So The plasma alpha 2 microglobulin level is decreased in myeloma and peptic ulcer, and it is increased in nephrotic syndrome, cirrhosis, and various collagen disorders. That is about alpha 2 microglobulin. Third one is the transcortin or corticosteroid binding globulin. As the name suggests, it will bind cortisol. And it is synthesized in the liver, and synthesis is increased by estrogen. Another one is heptoglobin. Heptoglobin plays important role in the conversion of iron by preventing its loss in the urine. Heptoglobin binds free hemoglobin to form a complex which is too large to be filtered by the kidney, and thus it prevents the loss of iron in the urine. So heptoglobin plays important role in the conservation of iron. Patients suffering from hemolytic anemia exhibits the low levels of heptoglobin. Another example of alpha 2 globulin is the thyroxine binding globulin. As the name suggests, thyroxine binding globulin will bind to the thyroxine, and it will be synthesized in the liver. It has an electrophoretic mobility between alpha 1 and alpha 2 globulins, and it will transport the thyroxine hormone, that is T3 and T4. Now we will discuss beta globulin. First, we will see examples of beta globulin. First one is the transferrin, second one is the hemopexin, third one is the C-reactive protein, which is the acute phase protein, and the fourth one is beta microglobulin or beta lipoprotein. First, transferrin. Transferrin is the non-heme iron-containing protein synthesized principally and largely in the liver. There is also evidence of its synthesis in the bone marrow, spleen, lymph nodes, and perhaps by lymphocytes. It exists in the plasma as beta 1 globulin. It is a glycoprotein with molecular weight of 70,000 Dalton. It is a true carrier of iron. Two molecules of ferric per molecule of transferrin. So one molecule of transferrin carry molecules of ferric iron, that is regarding transferrin. Now we will see function of transferrin. So transferrin involves in the transport of iron to blood to the sites where iron is required. Clinical importance of transferrin. So increased level of transferrin is seen in iron deficiency anemia and in the last month of pregnancy, because in the last month of pregnancy there is a more prevalence of iron deficiency anemia. And the low level of transferrin is seen in chronic infection as well as in the malnutrition. Second one is the hemopexin. Hemopexin, it is a beta 1 globulin. And it is synthesized by the parenchymal liver, parenchymal cells of liver. Functions of hemopexin. So hemopexin plays important role in the conservation of iron by preventing its loss in the urine. It binds with the free heme, not hemoglobin. The complex hemopexin and heme is too large to be filtered by the kidney, and thus it prevents the loss of iron in the urine. Remember, hemopexin binds with the free heme, not hemoglobin. Third one is the C-reactive protein, that is also known as the CRP, which is an acute phase protein. CRP is synthesized by the liver. It is involved in body's response to the foreign compound. C-reactive protein is named because it reacts with the C polysaccharides of the cell wall of the pneumococci bacteria. That's why it is known as the C-reactive protein, because it reacts with the C polysaccharide of the cell wall of the pneumococci bacteria. It is useful in differentiating bacterial from the viral infection, because level of CRP is highly increased in bacterial infection as compared to the viral infection. and the level of CRP rises when there is an inflammation or an infection. So that is about the CRP, that is C-reactive protein, and it is a example of acute phase protein. And the last one is beta 2 microglobulin. This protein form a part of human leukocyte antigen system. It is derived from myeloid and lymphoid cells, and it is normally synthesized at the constant rate. Clinical significance of beta 2 microglobulin. Plasma levels are increased whenever there is malignant lymphoid or myeloid proliferation and renal failure. Now we will see various NEET PG MCQs. Cigarette smoke inhibits the activity of, and the options are alpha 1 antitrypsin, ceruloplasmin, alpha 2 microglobulin, and C reactive protein. The correct answer is cigarette smoking inhibits the activity of alpha 1 antitrypsin. So the correct answer is E. Second question is emphysema is due to inhibition of, and the options are alpha 1 antitrypsin, fibrinogen, ceruloplasmin, plasmin, and alpha 1 fetoprotein. The correct answer is emphysema occurs due to the inhibition of alpha 1 antitrypsin. So the correct answer is A. Third question is which of the following protein estimation is useful for the diagnosis of neural tube defects, and the options are ceruloplasmin, transferrin, alpha 1 fetoprotein, and gamma globulin. So the estimation of alpha 1 fetoprotein helps in the diagnosis of neural tube defect. So the correct answer is C. Fourth question is which of the following proteins are acute phase proteins, and the options are CRP, fibrinogen, heptoglobin, and all of the above. So CRP, fibrinogen, and heptoglobin all are the example of acute phase protein. So the correct answer is D. Last question is ceruloplasmin, and the options are it is an alpha 2 globulin, copper binding protein, incorporation of iron into transferrin, and all of the above. So the correct answer is D, all of the above, because all the options are correct for the ceruloplasmin. So the correct answer is D. These are my references. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe Biochemistry Basics by Dr. Amit. And don't forget to press the bell icon so you can get all the notifications from it. Thank you.